All right, here's a video. Now that you have V3 installed, if you watched my previous video, you will understand how to put V3 in there. If you don't know how to, go look at my YouTube page and you'll figure out how to install the V3 version. If you put the V2 versions on top of V3, it's going to come fucked up. If you put the V3 on top of your old NWI Fire Sticks version 2.0, it's going to come out fucked up. There's just different coding and different ways the things that had to been done. So, say I hit home button, I'm going to go through like the last one. I'm going to, take as much time as I can because I'm repeating this over and over again to people and they're just not understanding it. So, once again, home button, settings, applications, down to manage installed applications. I don't have V2 anymore because I already installed V3 from my last video that you've seen. I'm doing this all in progression on the same Fire Stick. Once again, this is a 2014, November 2014 first generation Fire Stick without the Alexa or whatever bullshit on there. So this is my first Fire Stick I ever owned, and I've still have had it just because this is what I do all my work on. Say if I went into V3, and there's really no data on it, it's 7.58 megabytes, but fuck it, we're just going to clear the data. You can clear the cache, there's no cache there anyways. But see, now data's down to zero, cache is down to zero, whatever. You don't have to do any of this shit if you just installed V3, but I'm just giving you every nitty gritty little fucking thing that you can think of, so you don't have to ask me a million times how to do this, because there's a video of how to do every single thing that I do on these Fire Sticks. So I'm going to launch the application. Preparing for first run because I cleared the data off of it, so it'll pop up another screen with this gas mask guy, and then it'll pop up another screen there with the gas mask guy that says builds across the middle. Now the old one was the version 2 that had the Uncle Sam and all the directions and all that bullshit. This one you don't even need any of those directions, you just click the word build. See, I can go away from builds and go down to the power and whatever down here, but I want to click the word builds. Click the word builds. It's gonna do some thinking in the bottom corner over there. When this is done, you can, okay, first run help, okay, just hit the okay button, just hit the center button, and that'll kick that menu out of the way. Now if I want to install a new build, I'll go into here, into the builds menu. Now I just made an update today because I'm trying to make everything updated to right now that you guys can all see that your old ass version of NWI Fire Stick 2.0 can be updated to 3.0, and I wanted to make sure there's a new version because my last one was April 9th before this, so this will fix everything. And as you see in the builds menu, these are 2.0 only, which will not be, I'm not updating the old ass Kodi anymore or NWI Fire Sticks. So anything after this update needs V3 installed. So you don't want any of these. You want to go to the newest one. Always go to the newest date. This is my first V3 attempt. This is my second one. I was lazy and too busy. I didn't make a no adult one, but usually I make an adult and the no adult. So I'm just going to choose the adult one. The retro gaming build is for something different. You guys don't need it, because if I do boxes, I'd put a different retro gaming build on it anyways. So you guys don't need it and won't work on a Fire Stick really. So I'm going to click the May 15th V3 only because I have V3. I'm going to click the adult because I want the adult section. If I didn't want the adult, obviously I click no adult. Do what you'd like to do a fresh start. I don't need to do a fresh start because I already cleared the data. So I'm going to hit no to fresh start. Depending on the speed of your internet will be how fast it goes. As to me, it's taken 1 minute to do. If you do it on a box, it might go faster because they, you might be plugged in Ethernet. I'm going Wi-Fi on an old ass Fire Stick, blah blah blah. But you can see that it's doing its thing. like I said, boxes, phones, laptops, whatever I put NWI virus sticks on, you can do all this stuff from those devices. I'm not using my computer. All I'm using is this controller and the Fire Stick and my Wi-Fi, obviously. But I'm doing everything from these devices. Now, when it goes to downloads the file, now it's going to extract all the stuff. So when it extracts all this shit, it needs to extract with zero errors. You see the extracting errors, and it says zero, and it's installing all the shit. If it extracts with any errors, it's your Wi-Fi problems. Your Fire Stick either needs to be closer to your router, or, you know, if it's just an update and your Fire Stick works fine in your bedroom and your router's in your basement, and the update just doesn't work, move your Fire Stick to the TV closer to your bedroom or to your router and do the update, then move it to wherever you want. Because I've had problems with people, you know, their router's so far away, but the TV, you know, it works fine to watch movies, but this, you know, this big update is just, it just won't handle it because the router's too far away. So something went funky in the download, so that when it extracts the download, comes out a little fucked up. If you get one error, you're probably gonna get a fucked up bill. But as you see, there's zero errors. I never have any errors. My router's pretty close. It's like 20 feet away. After this video, I'll show you some other things. But basically, I mean, you can see it all working. You guys all have the same shit because this is the same stuff I've put on all your guys' devices. So when you guys tell me it doesn't work for me or I got an error, it's you need to reset your router. You need to, you know, turn off your Fire Stick by holding the center button down and this play pause button. You hold them together, and that'll soft reset your stick. That'll help your Wi-Fi on your stick. Other than that, it's your router issue. If you unplug your router for a minute, wait a minute, then plug it back in, then wait for everything to boot back up, and then blah, blah, blah. You can see it's nothing on my end. It's all on your end if there's a problem with any of these updates. So now the download's complete. To ensure all these changes, you must close Kodi, and you force close it. So I hit OK. And then I go to force close. Force close Kodi. Now you'll see the data jumped up to 810 megabytes. It's pretty fucking big. But we're going to clear the data now. So I'm going to launch the application. There shouldn't be really any updates because I made the build right before I made this video. Say if you do the May 15th update, July 15th, July 19th, whatever, and you install the May 15th update, it's going to have all the updates from May 15th all the way to whatever day it is that you decide to choose to do the update. So now you have all the new stuff. I moved Placenta down because some of the links are starting to get fucked up and I don't like it. Always my first icon. I'm just going to make a whole separate video now explaining how everything works. But you see how the build's on there. It's going to run a little slow at first until you start opening things, and then it's like oiling a glove. Once you open something, then, you know, like if I want to go to, Neptune or whatever, I want to watch a movie, I go to Neptune, it's going to open a little slow the first go. Now when I go to Neptune, movies in Neptune, it should open up a lot faster. See how it opens like a page in a book? And the first time it took a little loading, so you gotta loosen it up pretty much. One thing I suggest after installing the build, remember how it was like in the 800s or something like that? Let's go clean it one time. So we're going to go to clear cache. Do you want to delete these files? Yes. Do you want to delete this file? Yes. Done clearing cache. Now you want to purge packages. There's 9 packages. Yeah, you want to delete them. Okay, done deleting packages. Thumbnails. You sure you want to delete all the thumbnails? Yes. Please restart Kodi in order to rebuild the thumbnail library. So I hit OK. In order for me to restart Kodi, I just go to power and quit. Now as you see, the news feed stalled and everything stalled up. I can't do anything like press up or down, or I can press home, but home will just kick me out of there and not show me that it's actually shut down. So just let it do its thing. Sometimes it's 10 seconds, sometimes it's 20, sometimes it's a minute. That automatically shut itself down. I didn't do anything for that to happen. And then now you see that your data dropped down to 498 megabytes. In the right side over there. So from your 800, whatever the hell it was, it's down to 498, and that's as low as it's going to go right now until I restart a whole new build, or if you guys want me just to dumb down your build and make it real small and not have as much cool shit on it. So now when I launch application, all your shit's there, it's clean, it's brand new, it's running well. Everything should work on it because I just did the build today. If there's something that doesn't work, you guys can hit me up on Facebook and say this add-on doesn't fucking work. And then I will go in and get rid of the add-on and find a new replacement for it. Like Gen Reborn, I wasn't digging it anymore. It wasn't working at all, really. So I replaced it with Deceit. I'll make another whole video on explaining the Fire Sticks because people still can't figure it out after my tutorials that I sit here with hours and hours with them, and they come back and I teach them for another couple hours and I just don't have time. So there is all your stuff.